lecture, we are going to see the fourth and last iconic game of game theory, aiming and evaluating multi-objective decisions. This game is called non-cooperative game. A father has two sons and is proposing to each of them independently and singularly an agreement. The father is giving 1 euro to each son if he is accepting that he is giving 3 euros to his brother. We are now going to fill in the payoff matrix, using as payoffs the money achieved by the father and implying that the two sons are rational in taking their choices. Each of the sons is receiving 4 euro if both the sons accept the agreement. On the contrary, if none of them is accepting, both of them are not receiving anything. In the intermediate situation, if son 1 is accepting and son 2 no, son 1 is receiving 1 euro because he's accepted, but son 2 is receiving 3 euro. As a matter of fact, it is true also the vice versa. You could see that in this game there are two dominant alternatives, because accepting is the best option for both of them. As a matter of fact, accepting for both the sons is thereby also the Nash solution, as well as the efficient solution. Given this matrix of payoff, we would expect that the two brothers will cooperate. Actually, sometimes between brothers, situations like these are actually not converging so easily. Sometimes the objective of the player is actually not just the rational one. Between brothers, for example, it might happen that each brother is more interested in what they are receiving more than the other brother than in the overall money achieved. If we look at the problem with Disney's perspective, the payoff matrix is totally different. So, we are now going to fill in the payoff matrix considering the differential money achieved in relation to the brother. In this case, the value is 0 in the case that both the brothers are accepting, as well as in the case that both the brothers are not accepting. On the contrary, the value is plus 2 for son 1 and minus 2 for son 2 when son 1 is not accepting but son 2 is accepting. As a matter of fact, it's true also the opposite. In this case as well, there are two dominant alternatives, because not accepting is the best option for both the brother. As a matter of fact, not accepting for both the son is thereby also the Nash solution, as well as an efficient solution. Given this matrix of payoff, we would expect that the two brothers won't cooperate. Actually, it is more reasonable to imagine that brothers are not pushed either by the first goal or by the second goal, but actually by the combination of those. So, we are now going to fill in the payoff matrix considering the combination of these two different objectives, overall revenue as well as differential revenue achieved in relation to the brother. With this new perspective, in case of agreement, the payoff for both the sons is 4 euros, because 4 are the euros received by the father, but 0 is the differential revenue. On the other hand, in case of non-agreement, is always 0, because they neither receive money by the father nor have a differential revenue compared to the brother. Finally, in the two intermediate situations, the son that is not accepting has an overall value of 5, 3 euros received by the father plus 2 euros of a differential value from the brother. The son that is accepting has an overall value of minus 1 euros, 1 euros received by the father minus 2 euros of a differential value from the brother. In this case as well, not accepting is the dominant alternative for both the brothers. As a matter of fact, not accepting for both the sons is thereby also the Nash solution. But in this case, we recognize the prisoner dilemma, because the solution of the game is the only not efficient solution, so the worst alternative for the whole system. This game illustrates several examples of managerial choices. This game is a good representation of those decisions that apparently are key to address and is possible to identify the best option to take for the overall system. In reality, actual behaviors of players differ from the expectations. The reasoning for that situation is not that actors are not rational, but that we are modeling the problem taking into consideration just a subsystem of all the objectives that the players have. This is a key issue typical of several negotiations. It is in fact very likely that different actors not only have multiple objectives, but also some of those objectives are not made explicit at all by the actors.